friend said that dude was robbing locals over here, and then he did that as a way just to get back or some shit.
Who was robbing locals?
I don't know. I have to wait for Franny to come back.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if Franny's just fucking with y'all, but we didn't take no one hostage. We didn't rob no locals.
Oh, he's here. Perfect.
Oh, he's back.
Oh, hey, Francis.
He put his big boy pants on.
He's so ugly, bro.
I gotta take him serious, man.
Where's your mustache, man?
All right, Franny, tell these guys what happened with that one guy.
Where's the first bitch?
Yeah.
Okay, so listen. I was chilling, going to get some weed for my block, you know? My homies around the corner at the smoky shop over here, bro. You know, that lady in there, a few guys chilling, stoned out their minds. Like, damn, I'm like, how you do, bro? How you been? How life been, homie, bro? Because I'm a fucking talk, you know what I'm saying? And got to get up in that shit. And then they're like, yo, bro, what up, Kurt? And we like, oh, damn, bro. And then they said, oh, we got taken hostage by some GG guys. They tried to rob a bank. And I was like, I bet, bro, get the gat. And I roll down and kill a bitch from GG, bro, for revenge.
When did this happen?
Yeah, a couple hours ago, bro. Blah,
blah. Ain't no one took anyone as a hostage today. The only thing we've done today was a meth.
No, bro. Not today. The hostage was another day, bro.
When?
You want me to go get those fuckers over here, bro? You
yeah,
to
get them over here.
In front of
get
us,
them
bro?
Over here. I ain't calling them liars. I'm just saying, I don't know.
But where they are, bring them. Where are they?
You ain't calling them liars, huh? So listen, Marty, have you ever taken anybody hostage from those solo bitch?
Franny, don't come in little bitch.
Yeah, you yes, little man.
Come on then, bro.
Don't come in little bitch, Franny. Listen,
okay,
bring him down
bitch.
Here, bro. Oh, yeah, big bitch works. Big bitch works.
What, do you not see the fucking issue if you can't answer me, bro?
Bro, listen, just bring the people here, bro. I wanna hear what they gotta say.
Nope. I ain't trying to get my homies too, because you a pussy.
You just offered to bring them. Fuck you, Tomo.
Yeah, I thought about it, and I think different now.
Okay, well, either way, no one took a fucking hostage in Little Soul. And even if we did, right, you got your get back with Zuck, sure. Like, let's say it's at
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Then why rob a GG local? Why try to jump into our compound? Why throw Spotchy's car in the water? Why fucking shoot
what?
Future?
I didn't do any of that.
I don't know anything about that. I don't know none about that shit.
What the fuck?
My first time hearing about this shit.
Bigger bitch did all that.
Who, what
the fuck you just say to me, bro?
I'm not shooting anybody here.
We're talking. I'm not shooting nobody. I didn't even know any of this
Marty,
fucking happened, bro.
Marty, when I said we chill, I ain't done shit since, bro. Just chilling, bro.
Right, but why is Hush doing all this then?
Didn't do that, bro.
I don't know, you asked
so you didn't rob the GG local?
Nope.
You didn't throw
Oh, yeah. We were rolling up, we were underneath the, next to the lockers, and yeah. I didn't rob the GG local. It was a motherfucker standing there, and I was like, oh, and I third eye that motherfucker, started robbing him. We all laughed. I canceled that shit, and we drove off.
No, you didn't. You were circling around for 10 minutes.
No, we definitely did not rob it.
Listen, brother, why would I fucking lie? You think I'm scared of y'all motherfuckers? I'm telling you the truth. We started with we canceled that bitch and we drove down. Didn't chase down the key.
We did not.
Nope, did not happen. Did not happen either.
We're actually boosting.
Trust me.
So where'd the car go? It just fell itself?
Listen, I don't know who you're talking to or who you're talking about, but that wasn't us. Taco was with me the whole time. I'll tell you honestly, if I did it, I didn't do it. Think I give a fuck? Think I'm gonna lie to you? I don't give a fuck. I didn't do it.
Who was boosting, to be honest?
If I did it, I claim that shit.
In a red Subi,
I think he's
right?
talking to you.
Yup, red Subi, yup. Curtis Subi, yup.
It was me, him, Curtis.
Didn't get a garbage truck and try jumping in the compound?
No, hell. What the fuck I want to go over there for?
Not us, bro. We were boosting bees.
You guys got a compound?
It just threw
itself. I don't even know what car it is, bro.
I'm not doubting anyone did that.
I don't even know what car Zakit has.
Okay, and then why'd you shoot Future?
Because he's being a dick.
All right.
How was he being a dick?
He was kind of being aggressive with everybody when he got there, and he was talking a little shit to Francis. He didn't like that he was talking shit to Francis, so then he started talking shit to him. Then he stepped close to him like he was going to do something. So he pulled his AK, and then he still kept talking shit, so he shot him.
It wasn't something like I'm trying to look for a problem.
That's not how it went.
That's not how it went.
I can literally run you how it went the whole time. I wasn't talking shit to him. He was roasting my clothes. And I said something along the lines of, I can fuck your bitch sideways, just fucking around, right? And then he says, oh, I bring up the fact that, you know, Jack, he's running for mayor. He's my pops. So I'm matching him. And he's like, oh, I'd get Jack confused with a clown if he had red hair. People start laughing. I find it funny. I'm like, shit, I don't know what to say back to that. I just said, shit, I'm going to just act like I didn't hear it because I don't know what to say. And then Hutch, he gets an attitude. He's like, oh, you want me to repeat it louder? And then he just repeats the same shit. I was like, bro, why are you talking about my dad like that? Like, chill out. And then he's like, what the fuck are you going to do about it?
Wait, Jack's his dad?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What?
So, yeah, so I
hold on a minute.
Hutch.
I could fuck hold your on dad a minute. Sideways. Let me pause you. Never said it's what you going to do about it. You walked up to me after
said
that.
I literally said that. And then I walk up to you. You asked, all right, so you tell me, what am I going to do about it? That's when I walk up to you. I was like, so, like, what, you think you could just do this here, like, because you're on our block? And then word for word, this is what you said. You said, we run the city. You don't own no turf. And then shot me.
Nah,
word
exactly
for word, that's what you said.
Yeah, he shot you first, and then he said that.
He shot me first, then said that.
Yeah.
I mean, this motherfucker pulled out the gun, you walk up to him. What you think's going to happen, bro?
No. He pulled out the gun after I walked up to him.
Nope.
Well, I mean, you walk up to him, you can't. No. You don't think he's going to prematurely do something to you?
I mean, what does he shoot me over? Because he fucking called my dad a clown?
I feel like we were all joking, and then you took
exactly,
it
we were joking
thing, right?
Until he caught an attitude and said that.
I mean, it is his father.
Look, literally, I literally walk out. Look. Keep this in mind. Look, let me say what
I mean. He was talking about his bitch, no?
Bro, because we're talking shit. Look,
I mean, so where does it draw? Where does the line get drawn then?
Because listen.
Why does Hutch have the right to get mad for Francis if Francis knew it was a joke?
So why does he have a right to get mad for his dad if he knows it's a joke?
You ain't missing the point.
I wasn't mad that you were my brother, bro.
Listen, shut the fuck up, bro.
What are you talking about?
Hutch wasn't flexing until this fucker pulled up and walked up to him. That's when it ain't a joke no more. If you start flexing with someone, you're taking it serious. This motherfucker
bro,
was
I wasn't flexing.
No time. So what you walking up to him for, bro?
Look,
you the fucking
look, I'm
gonna
literally run you through the fucking beginning from the start, all right?
But we already heard this.
I pull up in a Christmas outfit. As soon as I walk out my car, motherfuckers is roasting my fit. I'm like, damn, fuck y'all roasting my fit for? It's a Christmas fit. Everybody's like,
okay,
it's
listen,
not even Thanksgiving, yada, yada, yada.
Listen.
And
it
then
off
I'm
as
roasting
jokes.
Back and forth.
Then
exactly.
It got serious. Where
yeah,
did
it got serious when he got an attitude and repeated. He's like, I'm gonna say it louder. Your dad looks like a fucking clown. And then that's when it's not a joke.
Flex on him, yeah.
And then I literally said, hey, chill, talking about my dad like that, because he escalated it by acting all fucking, like, with an attitude.
Did he get up
in
your face, bro, like he got to beat your ass, bro? Or did you do that?
Was that your dick hitting the table, Franny?
Yeah, sorry, bro.
Stop. Can you continue? Go ahead.
What Francis is saying, who made the first move physically?
What do you mean physically? I just said, hey, stop talking my pops like that. And he said, what are you going to do about it? And then he tells me, what am I going to do about it on my own block? I walk up to him. I'm like, so okay. What's the problem?
Walking
and then
up to
that's
him
when
is
he pulls his fucking AK
escalation,
out.
Right?
Nobody escalated
I mean,
shit until he pulled his gun out.
He's not going to wait to find that out, though.
Man, I'm not going to fight or shoot somebody or do anything over him getting an attitude. Let's talk about it.
You know what I mean? But he doesn't know that. If talking about
what
it can
mean,
happen
he doesn't
from here
know
to
that.
Here, as soon as you go like this to somebody, it's different, right? Becomes different.
Hey, no, because
I can pull a switchblade out and stab you in 2 seconds right now.
No, because
you know
look, I walked
but
up to him because now I'm having a conversation with him instead of just having a conversation with the circle.
I'm just saying, I wouldn't let somebody walk up to me like that without me wanting to pull something either. I'd feel a little bit vulnerable.
So then, what made him pull the trigger then?
Yeah, more shit talk.
What shit talk? What shit talk?
What did he say?
I can't remember. You said some shit when he pulled
I didn't even,
you,
I didn't even talk to him. I was talking shit to Francis
said,
the whole time because
okay,
me
so
and
listen.
Francis hey, roasted my face. It was my dad. I was just roasting him. I said, I'll fuck you
so
up sideways. He said, my dad
him,
looks like a clown. And I was like, I don't know what to say to that. So
what
that's
made
what
him
I
shoot
said.
Him was that he kind of got like, yo, you really going to do this right now on my territory? You really going to do this
but
right
did
now?
Did I say that?
And
that's not what I said.
What? Okay,
yeah, no,
what did
you said that shit.
No, I that's not what
like
I said.
That,
no, I did
okay,
not.
Okay, well, what did you say then?
I said, is this how you want to go about this? That's literally
okay,
what I said.
I mean, it's fairly similar. What's the difference?
The difference is why would you want to bring a gun out when we're just having a conversation about something this fucking petty? That's the difference. And that's why I said, is this why you want to go about, is this how you want to go about things?
I mean, I feel like we clarified
no
why
gun.
The gun got pulled.
I didn't take no fucking
like,
gun out. If I wanted to.
I feel
to,
like we clarified yeah, why would the gun was pulled, though. Because you stepped up to him, right? He felt vulnerable. Like
I did.
You could do
I was
there.
Having a conversation
so
with
gun.
Him. It went from being
yeah,
in a circle having
you.
A conversation.
He doesn't know that.
Bro, I've literally met him before multiple fucking times. I definitely know him.
Okay, so do you feel comfortable enough with him stepping up to you? We see each other at gas stations.
We fuck around sometimes. Like,
no.
What do you mean?
I mean, obviously he didn't.
We're not complete strangers. Like, what are you talking about?
I mean, all I'm saying is he obviously didn't feel comfortable, or why would he pull a gun?
No, he had an attitude from the get-go. I was even speaking to him. The first thing I hear from him
from the get-go, bro.
Yes, yes. Because look, the first thing I hear from you is, "Oh, you didn't hear it? Let me say it louder. Your dad looks like a fucking clown." That's what you said with an attitude. You literally yelled
at me. But again, my fucking boyfriend. Yeah.
But again, the way that you said, "I'm gonna act like I didn't hear you say that," like you hard. So that's why I was like, "Oh." He wants to say some shit like that. I'm gonna go on top of that.
You can have your own beliefs of how strong you are and whatever, but you gotta know, like, he's on his own block, right? You gotta just show some sort of respect. Like, he's gonna hold that shit down no matter what.
I don't give a fuck. Side.
Nah, you have to give a fuck though. You have to
hold down the dad jokes.
You gotta sit there and understand his perspective.
You gotta hold down the dad jokes.
I'm sorry, man. I'm gonna be honest. I don't give a fuck.
You just wanna sit here and be ignorant and just not actually wanna talk this out, bro.
Bro, I'm listening to you guys. I understand what y'all are saying, but you telling me to give a fuck? I just don't give a fuck.
I'm not telling you to give a fuck. I'm telling you to understand. A big difference.
I don't know how turf even gets brought into it in the first place when we're just chilling there racing.
Exactly. Nobody brought turf into it but him.
You brought turf into it.
What? I brought turf into it. How did I bring turf into it? How? I literally said, "Is this really how you want to go about things?" Then you take out your AK, shoot me, and then you said, "We own the street. We own the city. You have no turf."
One second. You didn't just say three stories all the exact same when you said you're going to do this to me on my own block, and even Marty acknowledges that you said that in the last three stories that you just told.
On my turf,
on my block. You literally have said that, Future, three times. Three stories you've said in a row, all three of them you included that statement.
All right, well, that's my bad. I completely forgot about that. That's my bad. I'll own up to that one. I apologize for that. So doesn't bring over the fact that what you did was like, bro, I wasn't even fucking speaking to you. I was literally just, me and him were going back and forth, just talking shit, cracking jokes. And then you say that shit. Like, what the craziest attitude. Like, trying to
build this. No. What did you say before? He said something that
I'm just saying, he said, I'm going to act like I didn't hear that. With a condescending tone.
It wasn't condescending. I literally said that because I didn't know what to reply to him. So I was just like, all right, I'm just acting like I didn't hear that.
Well, it sounded like to me, to Charles, and to Francis, that it was condescending.
End of the day, we was all talking shit. Who gives a fuck how it's perceived? That's all not bro. But you walk up to him, you start flexing. That's it. If you walk up to me, I do the same shit, bro. If I walk up to you, I expect you to try beat me if you want to flex, bro. That's what flexing is, bro.
Bro,
you
I flex. Wasn't flexing.
See what the fuck happened?
Instead of it being a circle, I literally just walked up and had a conversation with him one-on-one. I don't give a shit about what
your definition of flexing is. You walk up to somebody like you tough, bro, you flexing, you dumb bitch. It's that fucking simple. You did that, you got your ass fucking shot. I don't give a fuck anymore, bro.
Gang.
Damn, you pissed Franny off, huh?
Oh my goodness.
Listen.
I don't think it's that big of a deal, to be honest.
The question is here, like, where y'all want to go with this? I mean, it sounds pretty fucking...
It sounds stupid. I just don't understand because there was other shit was happening today. So I don't know what the fuck was happening.
Well, like I said before, Marty, I can go ahead and give you the honest truth. We did not throw no shit in your compound. We weren't looking for your boys. We didn't fucking go and rob your local all the way through.
Trust me, none of that shit was us.
All the way through, bro. You
hear Hutch talking though, right, Marty? You hear him talking though, right? Like, if he did some shit, he would admit to it.
Yeah, but
if someone likes the big dick, it's definitely Hutch. So. Right. If he said he didn't do it, he didn't do it.
Why in the first place even try to rob the local even for a second? What's the point? You know it's a GG local. You know
because
it.
Because you want my honest statement? The reason why I did it was because about 20 seconds earlier, we saw a local walking down our block with a katana. So when I saw your local, we didn't rob our own because we were trying to figure out how he had a fucking katana on his back. I saw your local and I was like, fuck it. I started it and we all started laughing. Then I canceled it and we drove off. It wasn't anything like I was trying to disrespect you on your own turf and I don't care about you. It was nothing like that, bro. I've done that to y'all. I've done it to GSF. I've done it to Ballas. I find it funny when everybody just fucking flies down there.
You saw a different local with a katana, so you decided to rob our local? What does that even mean?
It means I was just fucking dicking around, bro. Like, I was just messing around.
What does a katana have to do with anything on a different local?
Again, that's where my brain was at. I just saw our local, then I saw yours. I fucking robbed them. I don't know what you want me to tell you. That's just what I was thinking. I think everything through.
His answer is he was just being a dumbass and fucking off.
I'm just fucking off, man. I was just having a good time. Boosting bees and fucking smoking crack.
Okay.
You can blame it on the crack.
I mean, shit. I guess it is what it is. Whatever. I don't know. I don't really know what to say. Like when it's just I was being dumb, you know, like.
I mean, honestly, that's all I gotta say.
Take that shit more serious, you know. Like, we used to have a big problem with people just, you know, trying to. Some people, actually, Forehead before he was GG, he used to test response times on locals and shit. It came to a point where I would just see him, I'd fucking shoot him if he was even near our local. You know what I'm saying? We've had our experiences. I don't know if you guys have. So like, we don't take that shit lightly these days, you know. So. I don't know. It's again with the understanding shit, you know? Like, you gotta see our perspective.
I mean, I hear you. Like I said, it wasn't anything deep. I was just sitting there and I was like, you know, it'd be funny if I had these motherfuckers flying to the local.
I say we don't run that track anymore. I'm not familiar. I don't like being in that area.
I'm in on that.
I mean, you do whatever you guys want. It's cool.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Later. Nice to talk, guys.
Later. Mm-hmm.
Alright, boys.
I mean, it's his own fault for bringing Turf into it, and he brought his own fucking group into it and all.
Listen, man, at the end of the day, that motherfucker was trying to act hard in front of all those racers, and that's why I shot him.
I can't even explain how, though. He just, from the get-go, was acting hard with Franny. Franny's doing just the joke stuff. I mean, dude, right off the bat, the first thing you tell somebody is, oh, I'd fuck your bitch sideways. You've escalated immediately.
Exactly.
Like, what are you talking? That's, I wouldn't say that to probably any of you guys, and I've known you forever. You know what I'm saying?
He's being a little bitch, bro.
What the fuck
did
you say, my turf, bitch?
Shut up, please. Hold on. Hold on one second.
No! Yo,
what the?